Hello students, welcome to fourth session of Financial Account 3 lecture series. In the previous class we learned regarding admission of a partner and the various ratios calculation. Admissions, assume that Shravan Kaushik are the old partners and Chetan is a new partner to the firm. Assume that old partners Shravan and Kaushik have planted a tree and they have got 10,000 fruits at the age of 10 years and 20,000 fruits at the age of 20 years of tree, and they expected 40,000, 60,000 and 70,000 fruits in their respective ages. But after 20 years, they have added one more partner here, Mr. Chetan. What is the result here? After 20th year, Shravan, Kaushik and Chetan, all these three parties is having a right to share the fruits. But the question is, whether the Chetan contributed anything to plant this tree? The answer is no. Only Shravan and Kaushik has struggled a lot to plant this tree. As a result, on the admission of new partner, Mr. Chetan, so this two partners, old partners, has sacrificed their efforts. And Chetan has got some advantages. So now to set off these sacrifices and advantages, we have the concept of goodwill in partnership accounts. Let us see one more example. Assume that Shravan and Kaushik old partners and they have started SK Industries 10 years back. Business now worth rupees 10 crores and its profitability is 1 crore a year. It's not an easy task to start a business and to set up and to grow like this. But after this, they have admitted Mr. Chetan into their partnership firm. The question is a new partner contributed anything for the formation of the firm? The answer is no. Is the old partner sacrificed something? Yes, they have sacrificed their efforts. So, in order to set off these sacrifices and the advantage, we have the concept of goodwill. So, in this today's class, we are going to learn goodwill calculations. You have learned these concepts in your PU classes also, but you should know that it is little different compared to our PU studies. We are going to adjust these goodwill in partners' capital account only. We are not going to make any other adjustments. According to accounting standards, we are going to adjust all the goodwill aspects in partners' capital account only. So there are four such situations here. The first one, goodwill bought in cash and recorded in the books of firm. Goodwill evaluated to the extent of new partner. Goodwill already appears in the balance sheet and it is revalued and written off. Goodwill already appears in the balance sheet and new partner brings his share in cash. So these four are the major situations that you should consider. So here is a chart. So, which explains the basic four situations. Goodwill bought in cash, revalued to the extent of new partner, appears in the balance sheet and again revaluation, and here appears in the balance sheet and cash bought in the form of goodwill. The thing is, for each situation, there are different transactions. For example, for the first situation we have first three transactions. Goodwill brought in cash, goodwill distributed and goodwill withdrawn by the old partners. So for each transactions, we have journal entries. And these things that we are going to learn in detail. Let us start with the first one. Goodwill bought in cash and recorded in the books of firm. In this situation, there are three major transactions goodwill bought into firm. So for goodwill brought into firm, we have the journal entry, cash comes in, so bank account debit, credit the giver, so it is new partner has given the amount, so new partner's capital account. Whenever the cash brought in for goodwill, it is the entry bank account debit to new partner's capital account. So after the goodwill brought into firm, we have to distribute the goodwill to sacrificing partners. So for that reason, new partner's capital account debit to sacrificing partner's capital account. Goodwill received by the new partner and goodwill sacrificed by the old partner. So debit the receiver, credit the giver. And the third transaction, if the goodwill withdrawn by the old partners. So here, goodwill withdrawn by the old partners. So in such situation, cash goes out from the firm, so bank account credit, and old partners has gained the cash amount, so debit the receiver. So here old partners receives the amount, so their capital account debited. So old partners capital account debits to bank account. So let us see these transactions with some examples. So Shravan and Kaushik, old partners, so their started firm SK Industries and Chetan is a new partner. So here Chetan has bought 1 lakh rupees as his share of goodwill. So if he brought this amount, then what will happen? Bank account will increase. So firm's bank account will increase. So for that reason, our entry is bank account debit to new partner, that is Chetan's capital account. And the second transaction, so we have to adjust this goodwill amount with the old partners. We have to distribute the goodwill with the old partners. So this 1 lakh rupees should be shared among the old partner. So credited to partner's capital, old partner's capital account. So our entry is Chetan's capital account to debit 1 lakh rupees. He has received the advantage of goodwill. So debit the receiver. So for that reason, Chetan's capital account to debit to sacrificing partner's capital account, that is to Shravan's capital account and to Kaushik's capital account. So if we consider these two partners are the equal partners, equally sacrifice their shares. For that reason, 1 lakh rupees into 50% Shravan and 1 lakh rupees into 50% Kaushik's share. And the third thing, so these two partners withdrawn their share of goodwill. So if Shravan withdrawn 50,000 and Kaushik withdrawn 50,000. So in such situation, so this cash balance will be withdrawn by the partnership firm. So their bank balance will again reduced. So for that reason, our entry is old partner's capital account debit, because these two persons are gaining the advantage or withdrawing the amount. So for that reason, old partner's capital account debit to bank account, because so here bank account balance withdrawn from the firm. So for that reason, it is to bank account, cash outflows. So for that reason, you should remember three transactions. First one, cash brought into firm, bank account debits to new partner's capital account. And the second one, goodwill distribution, new partner's capital account debits to old partner's capital account. And the third transaction, if the goodwill withdrawn by the old partners, so old partner's capital account debits to bank account. And the second situation, goodwill revaluation. So in case of goodwill revaluation, we have only one transaction. So goodwill revalued to the extent of new partner. So in this case, again we have the same journal entry, new partner's capital account debit to old partner's capital account. So let us see these transactions. So here, ISK Industries, old partners and new partners. So in this situation, goodwill revaluation. So here, new partner will not bring any cash towards goodwill, but instead, so here, the firm revalues the assets and liabilities. So then they find out the goodwill amount. So goodwill revaluation, and they found that Mr. Chetan's share of goodwill is 50,000, and this share should be transferred to, or this benefit transferation, revaluation and distribution of goodwill. So for that reason, this 50,000 should be shared by Shravan and Kaushik. So for that reason, we have a journal entry, Chetan's capital account debits to old partner's capital account. Goodwill benefit received by the new partner, so debit the receiver, we debit Chetan, and old partners sacrificed goodwill, so for that reason, credit the giver, so here giver is old partners. So new partners capital account debits to old partners capital account. So that is regarding the second situation of goodwill revaluation. And the third situation, goodwill already appears and it is revalued and written off. So here two transactions are there. For goodwill revaluation, they have the same entry as in previous case, new partner's capital account debits to old partner's capital account. And for goodwill written off, we have separate entry, old partner's capital account debits to. So let us see this situation 3 with the example. Old partners, ISK Industries and Chetan. Goodwill already appears. So goodwill already appears in their balance sheet worth rupees 1 lakh and it is revalued. At the time of admission, they have revalued their assets and liabilities. According to that, Mr. Chetan's share of goodwill is 50,000 rupees. At this particular situation, the first thing we have to do is we have to distribute the goodwill. So for that reason, our journal entry is to credit the old partner. So here, Chetan, new partner's capital account debits to old partner's capital account. And the second is, we have to eliminate or withdraw this goodwill amount. So here, return of goodwill. In order to return off this goodwill, we have to distribute this goodwill or debit the partner's capital account. So here, 1 lakh rupees worth goodwill is shared between Shravan and Kaushik, 50,000 and 50,000 rupees. So our journal entry is old partner's capital account debit 1 lakh rupees to goodwill account 1 lakh rupees. And the fourth situation, goodwill already appears in the balance sheet and new partner brings his share in cash. It is a combination of first and second situation. So here we have to follow three transactions. Recording goodwill, brought in cash, distribution of goodwill, and writing off the existing goodwill. So for the first situation, as in case of first situation, the entry is bank account debit to new partner's capital account because the cash comes in and the new partner brought the cash. And the second one, redistribution of goodwill, which is as in the previous case. And the third one, writing off the goodwill balance already appeared in the balance sheet. Let us see these things with examples. Old partners, ISK Industries and new partner. Goodwill already appears in the balance sheet worth rupees 1 lakh. A new partner brings his share in cash. Whether they have given revaluation? No. So there is no revaluation of accounts. Instead, new partner brought his share of goodwill. So total goodwill of the firm appeared in the balance sheet was 1 lakh rupees, but a new partner brought only his share of goodwill is 50,000 rupees. So in this particular case, our first transaction is goodwill brought into firm. So for that reason, when the goodwill brought into firm, their bank balance increases. So for that reason, our journal entry is bank account debits to new partner's capital account. And the second transaction is distribution of goodwill. So for that reason, we have to credit old partner's capital account. So our journal entry is new partner's capital account debits to old partner's capital account. So next transaction is we have to eliminate this goodwill balance appeared in a balance sheet. In order to write off this goodwill amount, so we have to debit partner's capital account. So the journal entry is old partner's capital account debits to goodwill accounts. So you should remember these four basic situations first, and then respective transactions. What are the transactions which will appear under each cases? In case of goodwill brought in cash, we have three transactions: goodwill brought into cash, distribution of goodwill, and goodwill withdrawn by the old partners. And in the second case, goodwill revaluation to the extent of new partner, we have only one entry, that is distribution or revaluation of goodwill. And the third situation, goodwill already appears and it is revalued, already appeared in the balance sheet. So in such situation, we have two transactions. The first one, distribution or revaluation of goodwill, and next one, writing off the goodwill balance already appeared in the old balance sheet. And the fourth situation, goodwill already appears in the balance sheet and a new partner brings his share in cash. Whenever the cash brought in the form of goodwill, we have the first transaction, goodwill brought into form, and the second one, distribution or revaluation of goodwill, and the last one, goodwill withdrawn. Withdrawn or written off by the old partners. Goodwill written off from the form. So you should remember this chart. So if you remember the transaction, you can write the journal entries. But you have to remember under each transaction, under each situation, which transactions will appear. If you remember that thing, you can easily solve the problems of goodwill. So goodwill calculation is compulsory adjustment for all the problems, whether it may be the admission or maybe the retirement or anything. So for that reason, you should be very careful recording goodwill calculation. Hope you understood. Just take a small evaluation. Just recall the journal entries. Goodwill brought into form, the journal entry is bank account debits to new partner's capital account, and distribution of goodwill to sacrificing partners, journal entry is new partner's capital account debits to sacrificing partner's capital account. For goodwill withdrawn by the old partners, cash outflows, so old partner's capital account debits to bank account. And for the last transaction, write off goodwill, we are going to debit the old partners, so old partner's capital account debits to goodwill account. So if you remember these four transactions journal entries, it will be easier to complete any problem. So recall goodwill situation. In the first one, goodwill brought in cash. Second one, goodwill revaluation. Third one, goodwill already appears in the balance sheet and revaluation and written off. The last one, already appears in the balance sheet and goodwill brought in cash to the extent of new partner. So hope you understood the goodwill calculations. Keep watching and happy learning. Thank you.